हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ सेट. सो इन कंटिन्यूशन वी आर गोइंग टू अटेंड सम मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द एक्सरसाइज 1.5. नाउ वी हैड अटेंडेड फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन विच कॉम्बिनेशंस वी हैव जनरेटेड एज अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट फॉर्म. नाउ फर्दर वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इन विच वेरियस कॉम्बिनेशंस आर रिटर्न in form of the property. So that complement form we have to write with respect to given information. Such type of question you can attend in two ways: either solution as a complement form you write as a set builder form, or on basis of given information in a property form you generate a list of element and then go for writing its respective complement set. So anyhow it can be handled for evaluation of complement. Now in order to that somewhat we are going to attend from exercise 1.5 question number 3. Here is in third question, taking the set of natural number as a universal set, write the complement of the following set. So first of all here we are going to define universal set with respect to which we will write respective complement that is being asked in your question. So for all the parts you will suppose that your universal set is a set of natural number means containing all such elements or even all the combination here you are having. Now somewhat part we here we are going to attend. Let's look at the second part in which it is being asked x is available as, so that set we can write as any of the set form. X is available as x is an odd natural number. As I told just now, it can be handled in two ways. Either you list out here all the elements with respect to your set A and then go for writing its complement, or in a statement form also we can write it down. If we write complement of set A in a statement form, what we can write? X, where X may be even natural number, means odd combinations you cut from this U and write the remaining combination. And the another way, you list out first all the elements as a odd one and then write its complement form. So here if you look at a particular list with respect to the odd natural number, it will be 1, 3, 5, 7, like that up to infinity it can be moved. Now complement of set A means A dash, here you will write as U minus A, means from this universal set all the odd elements are to be cut, so you will left here with the only even elements 2, 4, 6, 8, like that up to positive infinity. The same answer you can write in form of the statement as, these are the x, what is the characteristic of x? X is an even natural numbers. So this way both the method you can use to find it out the respective complement form. In order to the same, somewhat more we are going to attend here as a part of question number 3. Now we look at one more part in which equation is available as a 8th one. In 8th part, if you look at given combination, it is your x, x plus 5 is equal to 8. This is only the form. If any of the statement form, you can write it's a reverse order or a complement form as such also. Now here, your x is available with certain relation with the constant. So before we move for writing particular solution, first of all, you have to make a separation of x, what the exact x is. So as an equation form this is available, so first make it sort out for x solution, means here x you will turn as 3. So now your question can be expressed as, or it can be written as, x, where x is equal to 3. So this is the shortest form you will have. Okay, so here you can see, with respect to your set B, you are having only one element as a solution of B. That means it contains only one element, that is your 3. So in its complement, what the elements or what are the elements you are going to include which are not equal to 3. Okay, so again in the statement form we can write, or a solution form also. So complement of B we can write is x which are not equal to 3, or you can say 1, 2, 3 is to be cut from this U, means 4, 5, 6 up to infinite it can be more. So this way you have to handle if any relation is being given. In some of the cases it may be possible that in place of this equal sign, inequalities are available. Inequality, that means what? Less than, or this way greater than, less than signs are available. So what is the reverse order you are getting, that is to be right as a complement form. So this way all the situations you can handle in easy way to make sure that what the elements you will get it in a complement form. Now while we were discussing about the property of the complement form, one law we have written, that was De Morgan law. So here in question number 4 you have to verify two statements for De Morgan law. And for that purpose, your three sets are available. One is universal set, second is set A, and third information regarding set B. So on basis of these three, we are going to verify your De Morgan law here. Both the statements are given here. So here, one of them we are going to be make a verify. So question number 4. In question number 4, U is given as 1 to 9, A is available as 2, 4, 6 and 8, B is available as 2, 3, 5 and 7. So first part we have to verify. As a first part, we will prove that A union B, its complement will be same as A intersection A dash intersection B dash. This is the first law for De Morgan. Second law you will write here intersection form, and union form you will make it prove. So for this part, first of all we will start with the left hand side. So pick up the left hand side here first, that is required as A union B whole dash. It can be evaluated in two parts. First you try to understand that what are the different parts we have to handle to get the solution regarding particular side. So here A union B and its complement is required. So here first of all, what is the need of the term? As a union B we required first, then it will be evaluated as a complement form. So first, apart from this solution form, we are going to find it out A union B separately. So here A union B you will write as 2, 4, 6, 8 combined with a 2, 3, 5 and a 7. Make them combine. Union B, know how to write it down. So try to maintain the order of the number. So in between 3 we'll insert 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Means 2 to 8 all the elements are included over here. Now next step is to find out complement of A union B. So here in a complement form we will write that is u minus a union b. Both the sets are available to us. So here this will be your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Make a difference with the union form that already we have listed out. That is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Write the difference of these two as a difference definition. Here all the elements from 2 to 8 will cut from this group. Remaining are 2, that is 1 and 9. So this will become as a complement form of A union B. Now this is the solution regarding left hand side we are having. Move towards the right hand side solution. First study what the right hand side terms required. Now here we require intersection of A complement to B complement. So first we will find it out A complement over here. Secondly, B complement here, and then find out intersection of both and check out whether the solution of this combination is same as solution of A union B and its complement. So now we move towards the right hand side solution. So keeping your left hand side solution aside, here is a left hand side solution. We are having two element, that is, now next is pick up your right hand side over here. Right hand side required A complement intersect with B complement. So obviously first of all we are in need of A complement as well as B complement. So further these two we separate, we evaluate separately. So here A dash means U minus A. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Your A contain elements as even numbers. Make difference of that. So here you will have a 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. These 2, 4, 6 and 8 are to be cut from here. Now move towards the B complement evaluation. That will be U minus B. Further it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Difference with B containing elements as 2, 3, 5 and 7. Make this element cut from this group 2, 3, 5 and 7. The remaining elements are as a B dash 1, 4, 6, 8 and 9. These two we have evaluated separately. Now come for intersection of these two groups. So here we list out A complement, that was 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. Intersect with the B complement containing element 1, 4, 6, 8 and 9. As an intersection, we look at the common elements. So here you can see this 1 and 9. These two elements are common in between these two complement form. So as an intersection of these two, you are having two elements as a solution form, that are 1 and 9. If you look at the solution of the right hand side, same group you are having, means in A union B complement, we were having elements as a 1 and 9. Here A dash intersection B dash, here again you are having elements as 1 and 9. So both are giving us same solution. That means you can say it is verified that left hand side is same as right hand side. That means you can state this law, A union B dash as A dash intersection B dash. Now the same way you can proceed for the second part, in which only one change you will have. For second part, what is to be verified? In place of the union, you will find intersection first and then make its complement. And here, in place of the intersection, you have to check out for a union case. So both will give you the same answer form. So the second part you can attend. Now move towards the next question, that is question number 5, in which Venn diagram is being asked for given combinations. In fifth one, no information regarding set is available. So here various combination in terms of A complement and B complement and even in a combined form is being asked as a Venn diagram form. So here we are going to list out first all four what are being asked in form of Venn diagram. So it is A union B dash. Second, it is being asked for all, we will go for Venn diagram plotting. Okay, now second it is A dash intersection B dash. Third it is A intersection B dash. And the last it is A dash union B dash. Now first try to understand what are the combinations available, and if possible to make them link, means if any one of them are with the same expression values, you can make them combine as a single form. So as a property of the complement, we have seen that these two are not a separate combination, these two are same. So here we will write first the diagram for A union B its complement, and it can be same as A dash intersection B dash. Means what the diagram we are going to plot for A union B and its complement, this will be the same for A dash intersection B dash. So first we are going to look at this form. When you are talking about two groups separately in general form, so somewhat intersection area also you will include over there. Because here we are not going to write particular elements for different set. So in general, if you are going to write Venn diagram for A union B, it's a complement. So without assuming any set in form of element, first of all we make a union form as an intersection of two group. So in general, when you are going to represent any of the two sets in Venn diagram, this way you will follow. Means somewhat common section area also we are having, somewhat separate section also we are having over here. Okay, now here this is your group A, this is your group B. Now we normally write A union B as this a whole section area. Now here what we required, complement of that, means apart from this common area, you will write this outer area shade. So as A union B, here as A union B, what we are having, this much area to be shade. Normal form A union B. But here we are interested to write complement of that, means here what the vacant area here we are having outside this section area, you will make it shade. So these are to be cut from here. Now what are the outer area you are giving here? This is outside these two intersection circles. This will be considered as A union B and its dash, and it will be same for A dash intersection B dash. So this will be the representation of this combination in a Venn diagram. Now remaining two also we try to make combine and find out the section area over there. So in remaining two parts, here as your third and fourth combination also can be linked by using the second law of De Morgan, that is A intersection B whole dash you can express as A dash union B dash. Means what the diagram you are going to discuss for your left hand side term, it will be same as a solution of a right hand side. Okay, now here what we required, A intersection B, as in the previous case we have written intersection of two circle in which somewhat intersecting area we were having. So here also in general we will write the same type of combination regarding two given sets. So here first intersecting area, this is A, this is B, and this is the common section we are having as a A intersection B. So in normal case A intersection we write this leaf area only. Now what we required, its complement form. When its complement form is required, that means this common section area we are not going to include here. Excluding this area, remaining whole section you will include as the answer form. So outside this leaf area, entire section we have to make a shade. But if you are using pencil, better understanding you will have that which one will be the common section area. You just leave this leaf area in between two groups as a remaining section. And then the whole reason you will make a shade to represent A intersection B and its complement. And this will be the same for A dash union B dash. So here what we have written, its complement form, that will be same for A dash union B dash. So this way any of the diagram you can represent by using the Venn diagram representation. So this was all about the complement form and various combination regarding the complement form. Now we are going to start with the somewhat practical problem, means in real practice what are the different combinations we are having, and small question you can handle on basis of a set theory. Before we start question, we are going to introduce here somewhat formula form and interrelation in between given terms. So let's try to understand what are the basic formula for two group and three group we can use to handle practical base question. Basic formula to handle practical base question is first one, n A union B. N means number of information relate with union of two set, or number of item available in two group in combined form. So n A union B you can express as NA plus NB minus NA intersection B. This is a standard form we will use while attending question based on number of items available to us. So before that we try to understand what is the meaning of each term. First of all, NA. NA means number of elements or information in set A. It may be available in a element form. It may be available as a number of items. So any of the term we can use over here. NB, that means number of elements in set B. Third one, N intersection B means number of elements contains in both group A and B. Compulsory it should contain in both group, means what are the common one. And the last term in A union B, that means number of elements contains in either group A or B, means in any of the group, if item is available, if information is available, you can write that combination as a union form. So first of all, list out all the given information in a question and then find out the required form. Now here be very sure that if information relate to both group is being asked, you will evaluate A intersection B. If information relate to any of the group, you will write A union B. So either or option you will carry for A union B, and compulsory both means and option you will carry for A intersection B. So be very sure about these two term concept, otherwise it make you create any confusion that which one is to be find out, which one information is being available. Now somewhat interrelation in terms of A union B, A intersection B, and even an A minus B are available to it. But before that, we try to understand one diagram from which somewhat it will be more clear. Here we try to look at one diagram form in which somewhat information will be more clear to you regarding some information or some interconversions. Now here, in a normal case, we are having this intersection form of two sets. A minus B we are studying, even B minus V also we are having. Now this circle represents set A, this circle represents set B. This is a common section what we have. So first of all, we make sure that this is your intersection of this given two groups. Okay, now here, just cutting this common section area, this remaining section means this much only, this is cutting this common section area. This shader region can be represented as A minus B. Now this side, if you come, this section you can write it as B minus A. Now try to link these three terms with the formula form. Here if you are willing to write N A minus B, sometime it will be required to you. What is this section area? N A minus this common section area. So it can be represented as N A minus N A intersection B. This is very important in interconversion. Many times it is to be used. So no need to mug it. Try to understand what we are going to write. This section area, that means to this whole group, this common section we have to make a subtract. So you will have as A minus B. Now one more term it can be related with this A minus B is the same, it will be N A intersection of B dash. Meaning of these two term are same, but many time in your question this term may be asked, so it can be write this way and have a solution regarding, because direct solution it is not possible to evaluate if information is available with the two groups. So be very sure that N A intersection B dash you can write is n a minus b, and further it can be written as n a minus n a intersection b. So this is the interconversion you will have. So same thing you can write in terms of the b minus a form, that is n b intersection a dash, that is n b minus a, it is n b minus n a intersection b. So these are very important interconversion we have to use while attending the question from the exercise. So till the next class, you revise this formula form, try to understand the basic concept. In book everything is clearly given in form of the diagram, so try to study the diagram and find out, try to understand what are the interconversion. So in next class we will continue with the question based on this formula form. Thank you.